You know, some shocking news out of Hollywood this morning that John Travolta's wife, actress Kelly Preston, has lost her battle with breast cancer.
I already buried a son. You want me to bury another, then you will bury me too. You swore to me in our own bed. You promised that you would not bring him into that world.
What world are you talking about?
That's her starring in the movie Gotti with her husband, John Travolta, when he paid tribute to her on Instagram, saying that she, quote, fought a courageous fight with the love and support of so many, unquote. And he thanked the doctors and the nurses who treated her. He and his wife were married for 28 years. She survived by their two children, 9-year-old Benjamin and 20-year-old Ella. And she also remembered her mom on Instagram saying, anyone who has ever been in your presence will agree that you have a glow and a light that never ceases to shine and makes anyone around you feel instantly happy. Thank you for making this world a better place. What a sweet message from a loved one. And her colleagues are mourning her. For example, actor Josh Gad tweeted, I'm in absolute shock. What a beautiful and amazing actress in person. Maria Shriver said Kelly was such a bright, loving soul, a talented actress, and a loving mom and wife. Kelly Preston was 57 years of age. I wanted to talk right now to Dr. Erika Hamilton, a director of the breast cancer program at Sarah Cannon Research Institute in Nashville. Hey, good morning, and thank you for answering our call this morning. You know, we don't know much about Kelly Preston's battle, except that she has apparently been fighting it privately to peers for 2 years. Can you derive anything from the length of time about what she may have gone through?
Yeah, you're right. You know, she chose to not share her diagnosis of breast cancer publicly, and that's such a personal decision. We hear of many that are public with their cancer struggles, but there are many more that aren't. And I think that's a tough decision for many with privacy concerns, having people see you differently, or having to face what's often a blame culture we see around cancer in the U.S. So we don't know a whole lot about the details of her treatment other than the fact that she had been under treatment for 2 years.
And we don't know if her family history predisposed her to breast cancer. How helpful to know if you are or not. I've noticed some of the like genealogy or the DNA test kit companies will be able to tell you if you have what I think is called the BRCA gene. Would you recommend doing that?
Absolutely. So that's based on your family history and whether you have a strong enough family history to qualify for that testing. And you're right, if you do harbor the BRCA 1 or 2 gene, that puts you at a significantly increased risk of breast cancer. But regardless, the majority of breast cancers in the United States are not related to the gene, and 1 in 8 women face breast cancer over their lifetime now.
And it's not related to that gene. Isn't that something? Any new studies or breakthrough in the research that you're watching closely right now when it comes to the treatment of breast cancer?
Yeah, there are a lot of breakthroughs. We've had a lot of new drugs approved by the FDA over the past couple of years for a variety of different types of breast cancer, triple negative, HER2, and hormone-driven breast cancer, to name a few. You know, I also think this really gets back to the importance of screening mammograms as well. You know, this is not the average case. Breast cancer caught early has excellent outcomes. Stage 1 cancer survival is better than 95% now. So it's vital for us to remember the importance of screening. It helps us catch cancers earlier when their chance of cure is higher. But despite this, with so many women being faced with breast cancer, and because of how frequent it is, it's a common cause of death among women in America.
You know what? Now with a pandemic though going on, people are already skipping appointments, like their dentist appointment. And I'm thinking that you must be concerned about women then skipping their mammograms.
We absolutely are. I think we're all facing the challenges of COVID-19 right now, kind of trying to figure out what's safest for us and our families. I do want to reassure everyone that hospitals and mammogram facilities are well equipped to maintain social distancing and assure that breast cancer screening is safe for all of us. I myself got my mammogram a couple of months ago, and it was a great experience, and I felt completely safe the entire time.
Good to know. And thank you so much for speaking with us this morning, Dr. Hamilton. Appreciate it.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me, Robin.
Yeah, and thoughts go out to the loved ones of the late Kelly Preston. Just a shocker.